Hey y'all, Master Elon here. So, where did I get that name from? I've been into Star Wars for a long time. I actually started using that name back on Jedi Academy, if y'all ever played that. So, figured that went along better with, the nature of the channel. Guys, I just lately. Some things about this game just really made me kind of frustrated, I'm starting to really lose interest in the game. I feel like things aren't really being fixed very slowly. There's a lot of money out there into this game. People have put a lot of money into this game. I'm just surprised by the lack of updates that we do get. I mean, this is one of the slowest games, even mobily, that I've ever had updates for. I mean, not saying we need daily updates, but my gosh, like there's a lot you can do in this universe. We're not really getting much of that. Too, this whole Vader thing kind of really frustrated me. Then too, there are people getting double and triple arenas rewards. Totally not against that, good for y'all, but it is based on the account. There's something with the accounts that does it. What I'm saying is that you can't, not everyone is getting these. Only certain people, so it gives certain people the advantage. I mean, you're spending money, you're not spending money, you're spending time. Whatever you are spending, you're not getting, the same experience. Everybody's getting a different experience, and it's kind of getting irritating. I mean, what else frustrates me? What else has been going on? Oh yeah, so found out speed leader buffs don't work in arena. They work everywhere but. So that's pretty cool. That means, Qui-Gon Jinn's leader skill, the paid character, one of the few, the one I got out of. However many dollars, the 6-star. Yeah, his leader buff doesn't work in arena. Not on the first round. Pretty well known, can't fix that bug. Okay. So that means Akbar and the Han, the whole argument that Han and Akbar are gonna be better. No, they're not. The speed buff doesn't work. Asajj and her saving grace of maybe having a Night Sister with leader with speed on her Night Sisters might improve it. Not gonna work. Doesn't work in arena. Works and everything else. These should be hot fixes. Like, fixed as soon as freaking possible. But they're not. So, yeah, and it's not just me. I mean, let's talk about Poe. Like, let's talk about the Poe argument. Poe's got really, really good speed. He's got super high health. He's pretty much got the whole package. Well, people are saying, well, Han could be better than him. Well, now we know that's not true. Now we know Han can't be better than him. Because the only way that Han could be better than him is if Han had the speed buff from Akbar, which now we know is not working. This has been going on for a while. Talking about dispellers. Dispellers are broken. Plo Koon doesn't work right. There's so many like lackluster heroes in the game that just aren't working the way. I mean, Asajj. I mean, her dispel is terrible. If I pop, this seems like a 100% chance here. If I get advantage on Phasma, and I use Asajj's dispel on that same team, it will take away all my advantage from Phasma's. Leader from her advantage and turn meter buff. It's just It just seems like the game is kind of headed in the wrong direction, and it's really disappointing because, you know, Star Wars IP, you know, this always happens. They hand it off to some crapshoot developer that junks it up. It's basically just a money grab. And that seems to be all this is as well. It's just a quick money grab. It's really disappointing. So, at this point, I'm kind of starting to say, you know, why am I playing this? They're making everything, I mean, as far as the PvP, giving people, not fixing it. We still, to this day, extra chromiums in the bags don't deliver. I mean, it's madness. It is complete madness. Like, who do you have, like, 40, like, chimps working on this project? This must be one of their other things they're doing. Because this can't be important to them. I'm just kind of fed up with it, you know? Yeah, I got some flack yesterday talking about Poe. But this whole thing started when somebody posted on the forums, hey, Poe's really strong. Is there a nerf coming? If so, you know, who should I use instead? Well, you know, that, and I agreed with the original poster that Poe is really strong, but I didn't think that he needed a nerf. I think that Poe is finally one of the first tanks that actually is doing what he claimed to do, which is, you know, taunt and tank some shots. Well, these guys just kind of dumped all over the original poster and just started, you know, basically just crap talking him, just insulting him. Like, oh, you're an idiot. You know, everybody else has been allowed their OP post, but not this guy. No, he's not allowed. So anyways, I kind of came to his defense because I'm like, you know what? He's not wrong. Poe does have the highest tenacity in the game. He is really, really strong. If you can't admit that, you don't know what's going on. I mean, at my tier, he's a definite advantage for the team. He's very useful. But, does he need to be nerfed? I didn't think so. I think maybe that's where the mistake was, and maybe starting this whole thing off by, oh, he's gonna get nerfed. Oh, he needs a nerf. Whatever point he was making. It's not that he needs a nerf. This is the main problem with the game, and the problem I'm coming to, take some other successful games out there. Like, you can take a little bit out of the MOBA playbook. You can look at League of Legends, and I played that season 1 and 2. But looking back at that now, and the hero roster and everything that it's got going, you have to say, you know what? This is a really well-prepared, really well-done game. Why? Because they have, to some degree, to the best of their abilities, really even out the playing field. So it's pretty much, it's not just one person, two people. Oh, these guys are awesome. It's pretty much a lot of people, I mean, that are pretty good and pretty viable. So, anyways, I just feel like this is going to be one of those games where it's just going to be a flood to the new. Of course. Yeah, fuck this. And these, this has changed. This was a crapshoot. Now, it is, they've modified it. I love the updates without updating the player base. So, we're increasing the difficulty of Galactic War. You know what? You guys are so afraid of your own shadow. You're so petrified of the community response because you guys have done such a terrible job. Now it's, oh, we need to make a change here. But let's not tell anybody about it. You guys are cowards. I'll tell you what, you're not getting another dime. I'm just sick and tired of it. I mean, we've got, like, greatest hits from Capital Games and from EA on this. I mean, they don't look out for the players. Their interest is in your money, not in you. You know, they've done so much dirty crap for so dirty long. Like, for instance, man, they, seriously, no joke, they were offering everyone a different package. They offered, for some people, they get to have a 21-day stem pack, $5. For other people, they get a 7-day pack for $5. How are you going to do that? We're talking about people in the same area, the same place, the same time, doing the same thing, same cell phone service, everything. See, I'm telling you guys to be aware. I mean, that is some crap. Some absolute crap. They do not reimburse you if you do buy Chromiums and you don't get what you paid for because of their bugs. They won't reimburse you. But, or they'll give you, it'll take weeks. You might get it, but it's going to take a while. So, yes, it is what it is. So, at this point, I guess I'm playing to play. Can't select off him. There we go. So, as it stands now, oh. Yeah, fuck you, CG. I don't give a shit. Yeah, not to be in a rage, and sorry if I disappoint some of y'all with my broadcast, but you know, at this point, I've been here since soft launch, and I'm starting to see the cracks. Starting to see the flaws. And you guys might too, so it's a fun game. It can be a lot of fun, but it can also be a bunch of horse crap. It's really frustrating. They really don't put their players first. They allow exploiters to get away with exploits. Before this, there was an ability mat exploit. Do you think they took away all the people's ability mats? No. They give some people double rewards. Some people don't get double rewards. So, I don't know. Guess I really need old Daka too, huh? I mean, if Galactic War is gonna get this hard, that basically means you need one other person to really get yourself right in this game mode. You need one other healer, because you're gonna lose him. For sure. And yes, this has changed difficulties. You guys can watch videos back. It was a steamroll. Now it's been modified. I'm tired also of just having so few heroes out there that actually do something decent. Man, that's getting old. I mean, it really is. Well, it doesn't seem this team has enough damage to actually do anything to me, but... Kylo Ren, man, just seems really lackluster. He doesn't really do all that much. He's kind of meh. Fix some heroes. You know, don't work on the update. Just fix the fucking heroes you got in the game already. Bring Han and Chewie up to a level where they can actually compete with the likes of Poe. Fix Newt Gunray, or Newt whatever the hell's whole kit. He's just crap. Okay, that was cute. Oh, great. Thanks, First Order TIE Pilot. You're the only one worth the damn. Yeah, you know, too, as I got called out, obviously someone watched the video like, you're because you spend $800, you think you... And it was that whole stupid argument that they put against a lot of pay-to-win players who were frustrated when they lost matches or whatever the heck, you know, and it's like, you're just mad and salty because we got better teams. That was not the context. You know, I actually do care about the average players. My best friends are free to play. So, it doesn't just upset me. Actually, it really affects me the least. I'm going to be taken care of. You know, with what I have now, it's given me a nice cushion for the pushing, so to speak. But, you know, I feel bad for other players. Because the most of the options that are free to play are the ones that don't work. It's not about me. Yes, I do have Qui-Gon. I've got old Ben. You think I got a problem? Like, I'm going to survive. I'm going to win these game types. I'm going to have a lot less trouble. I feel bad for y'all. And you know what? I want to reach out. I want to try Asajj Ventress. I want to use Asajj. She's free to play. Han Solo, he's a squishy noob. He is super squishy. He can generate turn meter, but on a damage team, he will blow your ass up. They will blow him up. Easy. Biggs, started to hear bad things. Magna Guard, he's free to play. He don't work. So Kitano, free to play. Slowest character in the game, nearabouts. Capped out of gear, shitty damage. What do you think they're trying to tell you? They're trying to tell you to gamble. Admiral Akbar, he might make Han good, except speed leader buffs don't work. Free to play. Boba Fett, he's pretty decent. How about Plo Koon? Nope. He's not good. Mace Windu, pretty much could free to play him. Tebow. There's the counter right there. Bring him on your team. Shit. That'll be awesome. You're going to do great with Tebow. I'm just saying. Fix the freaking characters in the game, please. Just do me a favor. How long would it take to go through some of these heroes' talents? Just a few. You fix them. And the ones who are broken. Leia, First Order TIE Pilot. Fix them. They shouldn't be attacking 18 times in a row. I own them. I don't agree. See, I'm not like everybody else. I'm not like the person who... No, this is broken. I want to use that. I play characters who are considered underpowered. I love to do that. I love to take them and win with them. But that's not going to happen on this game, is it? Now, as you see... I'm wasting... all my stuff. Shoot me. I'm letting them waste all their abilities. So. Scroll to the bottom. Takes forever. I don't remember if Barriss's timer is up or not. So that makes her a wild card to bring in. I don't remember if any of these healers' timers are up. What match am I on? Last? Near last? You're gonna get countered. He's damaged down, isn't he? Or is that a dot? Better drop everything we can on these jerks. Dodged. Can't select. Cannot target him. Dang, maybe I should level his thing up to 6. So, because that would have been off a cooldown there if I leveled his ability up to 6. Yeah. But it's definitely time to stop taking this game quite so seriously as far as wanting to be competitive and wanting, because that's pretty much gone out the window. Lightning bolt. Nope, he doesn't have it. How long can we keep this guy alive for, I wonder? Not too long. Somebody gonna get him. Oh, this girl. Eat it. It's your problem now, sucker. We'll try. We'll see if we can save him. Yep, looks like we're gonna. Save her. Sorry. Never seen a female stormtrooper before today. So. Yeah. You knew that was one thing. When the licensing began, there were going to be people who fell through the cracks, for sure. Love that. That is so cool. That's a neat little trick, isn't it? Start without advantage and kill someone and you get 3 shots. That's cool. And see, because they don't have a lot of big blow-up damage here, Han's gonna actually survive this one. He's long enough anyways. You got him. You did it. Time to die. So, sorry, I guess today's another rant, but I'm still on about Vader. Still on about a lot of things that are wrong with the game, and as you get further in, you know, you start to gamble with different heroes. Oh, this could be fun, that could be fun. But then you realize, you're like, nope, you don't have those kind of choices. There, you will find out that it's not as good as you think it is. Tiny had a video yesterday regarding free-to-play, play-to-win. I have to disagree with him on this one. You know, he's not a paid player, so when he's on the outside looking in, it's like the grass is greener. He's thinking, oh, you know, they can do whatever they want, whenever they want. They have all these advantages. He's kind of wrong. It's not true, per se. Why should we get my ass kicked by this? It's going to be rough. Oh, God. He built an even more brutal team than before. But I'm lucky, I guess. See, that is good. That does suck that he can do that. That Qui-Gon Jinn is, like, as an AI, is not stupid. And First Order TIE Pilot leads to the whole team getting offense up. It's brutal. Now that is some pro play right there. But see, Poe, I mean, he pretty much is going to lead this meta with that. I mean, there it is. That's pretty much over. Very reliable offense up on that. I should have gone for First Order TIE Pilot. These call and assist. Super strong. But yeah, there's kind of a lot of stuff about this game that could be improved. And, fortunately, with the push for new content, I don't really think we're going to get too much of that. Oh, I got a Barriss Offee shard. Barriss Offee. So, this is what it is, guys. Appreciate you watching. You know, hope I haven't disappointed you, but I'm just kind of being totally square with you about the state of things right now when other people have their own frustrations with it. So, I don't know. Tell me what you think in the comments.